Hello everyone, welcome to Dusky Board. Today we are going to discuss all and everything about coronavirus. Now what is coronavirus? The recent outbreak of coronavirus has raised many questions. Now first, let us discuss about coronavirus. Coronavirus is not a single virus but a large family of viruses. That is all the viruses from MERS, SARS, everything come under this particular virus family. And the recent coronavirus outbreak is being named as N coronavirus, that is novel coronavirus. So what is novel? Novel is the word which is alternately used for new. Now what are the illnesses or symptoms? So when coronavirus family attacks a human being, we can see illnesses ranging from a common cold to very severe diseases. Okay, now how is this virus transmitted? This is a zoonotic transmission, that is this type of virus transfer from animal to the human being. For example, if you consider SARS, it has been transmitted from civet cats, whereas MERS is from camels. Now very recent N coronavirus is supposed to be transmitted to humans via bats. Now here question may arise in our minds that if the virus is being transmitted from bats to humans and humans are being so widely infected and even there are cases of deaths, then why aren't any cases recorded for bats? Why are not bats dead when virus are present in bats? Now let us understand how a body respond to a virus attack. A virus is unlike bacteria, is not an organism, so it cannot thrive on itself. So it always attaches itself to a human cell and it reproduces inside the human cell till the cell bursts and dies. Now to respond and to save itself, a body primarily does what is called as inflammation, that is a quick increase in the blood flow in the infected area, and secondly it sends antibodies to attack. In the case of bacteria, these antibodies attack the bacteria and kill the bacteria, whereas in the case of virus the process become a bit complicated because the virus is inside our own body cells. So in the case of bats, if we see the inflammation which is usually seen in mammals, which is seen in humans, which is seen in mice, the inflammation is very very high. Due to this high inflammation, there is the second stage, that is the infections and other diseases spread very quickly in the body, which can lead to the severe symptoms. Whereas in the cases of bats, there is no inflammation due to the presence of this type of viruses, and this can be seen as an advanced version of this immune system. So bats are not since affected due to presence of this type of bacteria. So next, if we come to the symptoms, if a person has been infected by coronavirus, the symptoms we see are mostly cough, shortness of breath, respiratory symptoms. Yes, if you observe here, the main thing you observe is mostly our respiratory tract is being affected, because when virus attack a cell like human body, usually viruses have a tendency to attack specific cells of the body. In the case of this N coronavirus, it is mostly affecting your respiratory cells. So the major damage which is done will be primarily done to your respiratory cells. So in very rare cases and severe cases, it can lead to pneumonia, kidney failure and even death of the person. So how can you prevent yourself? Now once the virus attacks your body, the process of cure is a little bit complicated, but when you talk about prevention. Prevention is always better than cure. So prevention can be done by regular hand wash. Why regular hand wash? Usually viruses cannot sustain in air. They usually die because viruses need a host cell in order to reproduce and survive. So in the air, they lose the capacity to survive and they eventually die. So when usually how is this virus transmitted from human to human is by bodily fluids. That is when you sneeze, when you cough, or through this phlegm, which is present on any surfaces. So when you come into the contact with a person, there are very high chances of this virus transferring from person to person. Or when you come in contact with the surfaces which have been contaminated, that is not for very long time they can survive outside. So whenever you touch or when you go into contact with such areas, when you wash your hands properly, this can help you prevent from this type of viruses. And this, friends, can be applicable to any type of viral infections. Now, as of February 2020, more than 800 people are dead because of corona and coronavirus, and more than 37,000 people have been infected. But the brightest side to see is that mortality percent is only 2%. That is, if 100 people are being affected due to N coronavirus, only 2 people out of it die, and only 20%, like 20 people in 100 people, suffer from severe disease. Most of the coronavirus, the disease can be addressed properly with the medical intervention. So the deaths which are being projected is the tip of the iceberg, and the usual symptoms and the diseases can be addressed with the proper treatment. So in coronavirus, average person passes it to 1.4 to 2 other people. Let us say if one person is affected, it is easily transferred to 1 to 2 other people. In the case, let me compare this, in the case of common flu, usually a person transmits this to 1 to 6 persons. So it is very less in compared to common flu. And recently, international public health emergency has been declared in the wake of this outbreak. Now, a few cases have been noticed in other parts of the world, but this has not been very much widely spread. So as of now, it is endemic to China. This outbreak is endemic to China. Now let us talk about how can this end coronavirus can be addressed or end. Now, first possibility is it becomes endemic like other coronaviruses, like we discussed SARS and MERS. This becomes endemic. Now, how do this type of viruses become endemic? First thing is, when winter to summer, usually the protein layer outside the genetic code present in the center of virus, the protein code becomes harder in winters. So during cold and dry weathers, this protein layer becomes hard. So it increases the lifespan of the virus in the air. So in the air, the virus lifetime increases, by which it is easily transferred from person to person, transmitted from person to person. So in summer, the lifespan decreases, and usually eventually the virus die quickly. So the spread of disease is way less, it is decreased. Next, by limiting the measures, then how can you, by limiting, in the case of SARS, like in the case of SARS, we can follow some quarantine measures, restrictions, awareness, screenings at the airport, by which we can limit the spread of this disease, and eventually it may disappear. Or like H1N1 and Zika virus, or not Zilla, it is Zika virus, it can affect fewer people than it did at the beginning of the outbreak. But what is the challenge? Challenge is that unlike SARS, and coronavirus show very less symptoms and sometimes no symptoms in the affected person. So tracking of this transmitting of diseases from person to person becomes very, very challenging. Then the last possibility is development of a vaccine. Now, development of the vaccine is a real hope for which we are looking forward to. Now, what is the brighter side to see is that the mutations in the case of coronavirus are less than that compared to the common flu. So what happens is that when the mutations are more, there is the chances of developing of new viruses inside the body, for which it is very hard for the body to fight, and the defensive function of the body has to start from the base as the diversification of the virus increases. The body again has to start from the basic in order to fight with the virus. As the mutations are less, the diversity is less, and it is easy for the body to fight. So in the case of N coronavirus, the mutations are low. So for us, it is a positive point because we can easily develop the vaccine. If you compare the viruses like Ebola, it took 20 years for scientists to develop the vaccine, whereas in the case of SARS, it took us 20 months to develop the vaccine. So now we are in the hope and looking forward to the development of vaccine for N coronavirus, so that it can cure people who are suffering from this threat of coronavirus. Thank you, friends. If you have any queries, please do mention in the comments below, and please do subscribe to Dusky Board.